This tutorial explains how to create a vase mod. Blender version 3.0 or higher is recommended. Delete unnecessary objects on the start screen. Press A to select all, then press Delete or X to delete. Click Add, Mesh, Cylinder to create a cylinder. Switch to Edit mode to change the shape of the model. Press 3 to enter face select, and click the top face. Press I to inset, then slightly move the face inward. With the top face selected, press numpad 1 for front view, then press Alt-Z to enable X-ray. Press E to extrude downward, and press Z if the Z-axis isn't active. Press Alt-Z again to disable X-ray. Press Ctrl-R, scroll for 6 loop cuts on both sides. Click once, then press ESC. Press Alt-Z for X-ray, then press numpad 1 for front view. Click Proportional Editing to enable it. Drag to select edges, then press S to scale. Scroll the mouse wheel to change the proportional size. Press Alt-Z to disable X-ray, then press 2. Press Shift-Alt to select the edges, then press Ctrl-B to bevel by dragging outward. Press 3 for face select mode. Select inner face, press I to inset, then press M at center to merge. Press 2 for edge select, then hold Shift-Alt and select the edges. Press Ctrl-B to bevel, then scroll wheel up to add an edge. Use the drop-down to switch to object mode. Right-click the mesh, then choose Shade Auto Smooth. Set angle to 60 in the bottom left panel. Open Viewport Overlays and enable Statistics. Polygon count is shown at the top left. Be cautious to not let this get too high. Click Modifiers in Object Mode and apply Smooth Modifier. Disable Proportional Editing. Switch to Edit Mode, then press 2. Hold Alt, double-click the edges, then right-click Mark Seam. Hold Shift, drag to select the edges on both walls, then right-click to select Mark Seam. Press A, open UV view, drag to select all, then right-click, unwrap. Press 1. For horizontal, drag vertices. Then press SY0, enter. For vertical, drag vertices, then press SX0, enter. Press 3, select face, press L, then right-click, follow active quads. Press 1. For horizontal, drag vertices, then press SY0, enter. For vertical, drag vertices, then press SX0, enter. Press 3, select face, press L, then right-click, follow active quads. Use L to select, S to scale, and G to move. Inside the Shading tab, click New, drag Base Color, then search for Image and click it. Click New, name it Diffuse, set Color Alpha to 0, then click New Image. In the Texture Paint tab's toolbar, click Fill, then pick a color from the palette. Click the origin area to fill color. In the toolbar, select Brush. Then pick a color from the palette. Draw shapes where you want them, then adjust the position and direction. In Paint View, select Image, Save As to save your work. In edit mode, press 1, then select the center vertex. Right-click, then choose Snap Vertices, cursor to selected. Switch to object mode. Right-click Mesh, then select Set Origin, origin to 3D cursor. Press N. Set Z location to 0. Open inZOI Kit, click Filter, then select Static Mesh. Find the mesh you need by either searching or scrolling. Right-click the asset, uncheck Nanite, then export as FBX. Import the FBX via File, Import FBX. Press Alt-Z, select Vase, then press S to scale down. Press Alt-Z to exit X-ray, then delete imported meshes. Rename the mesh by double-clicking its name. Export your file via File, Export, FBX. Open the kit and click the ModKit Home button. Click Build, scroll or search, then click arrow and select Create New Mod. Enter the furniture ID and mod project name. Enter any value here. Once done, click Create. Create a folder in your desired location to store asset files. Double-click the mod. Import the mesh and icon, then make the icon 256 by 256 in size. Click MI Prop, name it and create it. Select the new material, then import Diffuse, AOMRD, and Normal Textures. Download AOMRD and Normal files via View Details. Open Mesh folder, then double-click Static Mesh. Add the new material in the material slot. Check Enable Nanite Support, set Fallback Target to percent triangles, then set Fallback Triangle percent between 5 to 25. Click Apply Changes. Nanite optimizes high-poly models for real-time rendering. Fallback mesh is shown when Nanite is disabled or unsupported. Go to Collision, add box Simplified Collision. Collision detects physical interaction between objects. Click Save. Click the String Table folder. The String Table is a file with names and descriptions of in-game items. Display name is the in-game name. Display description is the in-game description. Enter any values here. Click Save. Click the arrow in Mod Project, then select Create Local Mod Package. Make sure the path is set to Document, inZOI, Mods, then select Folder. You can test the mod locally using this method. Sign up for an account on CurseForge, then select UGC, Sign In. Enter the email for your CurseForge account. Enter the verification number sent to your email. Once logged in, click UGC, Share UGC. The mod page thumbnail must be 400 by 400 pixels. When everything is filled out, click Create Mod. You can make changes even after uploading.